there's one thing I'm not ready for, it is five screaming queens singing happy birthday.
Set.
Boys in the Band is about a group of nine men who assemble in an apartment to celebrate a birthday for Harold.
Happy birthday.
Takes place in 1968, right before Stonewall, at a time when gay identity was still something that was not fully integrated in many people.
No, it's the delivery boy from the bakery.
Ask him if he's got any hot cross buns.
The story is so layered, and there's so much there.
Good evening.
It's really an exploration of the psychological dynamics between them as influenced by the socio-political climate of the time.
This old college friend of mine is in town, but he's straight.
Do you really think he doesn't know about you?
My character is Alan McCarthy. Alan comes in and disrupts everybody's good time.
I couldn't care less what people do as long as they don't do it in public or try to force their ways in the whole damned world.
Michael's challenge is he's broke and he tends to spend his money frivolously, all stemming from the fact that he's so deeply still conflicted with who he really is.
Happy birthday to you.
Blow out the candles, Mary, and make a wish.
There's something for everybody in here. It's a definite kaleidoscope of different kinds of gay men.
Am I stunning?
Donald is trying to figure out how to live.
What are you so depressed about? I mean, other than the usual everything.
Hank's kind of an outsider to this group. The reason that he is part of this group is because he cares for Larry so much.
I love you.
Hank, why did you do that?
Because I do love him, and I don't care who knows it.
Larry is the only one who is in a relationship in this group of friends. So Larry struggles with monogamy.
Who are you calling?
I refuse to forfeit my turn, and it's my turn, and I'm taking it.
Emery's a very authentic human being operating in a world that doesn't know how to deal with that. He's a very effeminate man in 1968. He's an effeminate man of color, and he's in a world that wants to be super heteronormative. He is a proud out gay man, and a lot of his gay peers can't really handle that.
Ready? I'll be your topless cocktail waitress.
Please spare us the sight of your sagging tits.
I think Bernard is very comfortable in his own skin and the fact that he is two minorities. He's gay, he's black, but he's also an intellectual and he's in New York City.
I know this game you're playing.
Harold's somebody who's filled with self-loathing. He knows himself very well and he knows who he is and how he moves through the world pretty unapologetically.
Are you good in bed?
I try to show a little affection. My character is Cowboy, who is a hustler.
Keeps me from feeling like such a whore.
Cowboy's main challenge is a sense of belonging and having any kind of real community.
Doing this revival and telling this story again, it's been so long and we have come so far, and you can be a better version of who you are by knowing what came before, who came before.
I hope that this will stand the test of time and be something we can look back on and go, we were there and now we're here, and let's thank the people who lived through that and got us to this place.
I hope this film provokes a conversation about how much has changed and how much still hasn't.
What's so fucking fun?
You remember life.
Life is a goddamned laugh riot.
Oh, there's nothing quite as good as feeling sorry for yourself, is there?
Nothing.
This is gonna be fun.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to the Netflix Film Club channel to get our latest exclusive videos. Plus, hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.